When people first get into SUP, they often buy an all-around board and adjustable paddle. What they don't think about is the increased drag you get with an all-around board, and the increased torque on the shoulders from a larger paddle blade. There isn't anything wrong with an all-around board or a beginner paddle, adjustable or not. These boards are amazing options for those learning how to SUP and figuring out which disciplines, i.e., surf, race, yoga, touring, they like best. When entering the sport of SUP, people often grab a less expensive paddle to go with their beginner board. Grabbing an adjustable is a wise choice, because you can experiment with the length and getting the most out of your paddle stroke. Some people will be more upright paddlers and need a longer length, and others will use more body and need a shorter shaft. However, many less expensive, entry-level paddles have big blades. Some assume that they will get more power per stroke, and thus more glide and go further. What they don't consider is their muscular ability or technique. Larger blades are more taxing on the muscles, and although paddling is a low-impact sport, each stroke is still an impact. A larger blade equals a larger impact. Now pair this larger impact each stroke with undeveloped technique on a board with higher drag and you've set yourself up to potentially wear out your shoulder muscles, or worse yet, cause injury. We're not in the business of scaring people away from paddling, we want everyone to go out and have a great time, safely. But, we recommend high-quality paddles like those from Quickblade Paddles, www.quickbladepaddles.com. These guys know how to make great paddles and a quick online search will confirm that. When you get the urge to enter your first few races, keep in mind that if you're on an all-rounder with a large paddle blade that you actually have more force on your muscles than the pros do. When you get that competitive spark as someone creeps up on you and you want to punch it into a higher gear, remember that the all-around board you're on may have a lot of drag, and that the large blade on your paddle will have quite a bit of resistance. This could be a recipe for an injury. That is why we recommend former athletes or people who have a competitive history always go with a displacement hull SUP, http://supspecialists.com/displacement-hull-sup. Even the casual paddler would benefit from this type of hull design versus the typical planing hull board.